Good morning, people. It is Monday.
Good morning. Good morning. People, it's 1:47 p.m. and I'm just drinking my coffee right now. Okay, I woke up like this. No, just kidding. I woke up looking worse than this. Can you imagine? Anyways, I'm at the office today. What is this? I don't know what I was doing. I was just on the computer fixing, responding to comments on my channel, editing some stuff that I posted. People, if you get confused, because with my new iPhone 6, like I just started using it this past week. It's been a week since I've had it. About a week ago, yeah, so I haven't figured out, I'm uploading from this phone, but, like, on my own old phone, I don't know how it happens, but there was some way that it would upload, but when it would upload, it would be too unlisted, so, like, you guys couldn't see it right away, because, before, you know, I like to go on a computer before I, you know, make my videos public so I can, like, stabilize it because, you know, I hold my camera so it's all shaky and then people always write in the comments, oh my god, like, why is this video so shaky? And it's like, okay, I didn't have time to go to a computer and fix it, so chillax, okay? Anyways, and then I do monetize my videos, most of them. And like add links and, you know, all my social media stuff. So that's why I like to upload it unlisted until I can get to a computer and fix it. So it's like all flawless for you guys. But on this phone, I don't know how it happened on my old phone because they used to not do that. And then all of a sudden it started listing them as unlisted. And I was like, okay, cool. This is perfect. And then this phone is uploading them as public. So, like, I just uploaded, like, 4 videos this weekend. And, like, people have already watched them. I was like, no! You weren't supposed to see that. So, if you guys get confused by that, that's why. But my head hurts. It's like, I basically just woke up. I mean, I woke up. I set my alarm for, I think, 9. But I hit the snooze, or I turned it off, and then I slept for 2 more hours. And then I was, like, so dead at my house, like, I don't want to go. Because, people, this is supposed to be my spring break right now from the studio. But I still have to come and work here. Like, honestly, people, I don't get any vacation working at my dad's office. My dad always told me there's no vacations at Slick Patrol. Oh, oops. There's no vacations in this office. There's no vacations. So I have to come here. But what I'm going to plan to do is work today and work tomorrow. So then I can have Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. Free from work. Do you feel? Oh my god, aren't I so smart? My head really hurts. What was I gonna tell you guys? I'm gonna tell you something else. Oh, that guy is probably gonna come soon. People. No. Because it's almost 2 o'clock. He usually comes around 2. It's like 2:51 right now. 1:51. What? I don't know, people. But I will talk to you late. People, I'm supposed to leave the office in like half an hour, probably. Let me see what time it is. Oh, I can smell my own BO right now. Okay. Yeah, like 29 minutes. Because I'm going to meet one of my friends, which maybe you guys will meet her. Anyways, more on that later. Let me just tell you this what right now. So that guy that, you know, that I hate, that old man that works for my dad, he came in and he was like telling me something and I'm like, obviously, I don't care. So he was telling me something. I was like, I don't know. Like, he always acts like I know what he's talking about. I don't know shit about what you have to do. I just know what I have to do. Okay? My dad doesn't tell me everything because that doesn't concern me, so why would he tell me? So don't talk to me about that stuff. So he was, like, talking to me about some issue he was having. He's like, oh, when is your dad? Is your dad at home? I was like, why would he be at home? It's Monday. Stupid. And, like, is he ever home on a Monday? No. He's always here. Like, if he's not physically in this office, he's, like, his stuff is here and he just went to go run an errand or whatever. Like, he's so stupid. He acts, like, so dumb. Anyways, so he's like, oh, well, I have this problem. I'm like, I don't know. I don't know. Just, so he, like, wrote, like, this, like, long letter to my dad. And he left it on the table, and I thought it was, like, whatever, something stupid, because, like, it's him, so everything he says is stupid. So, then my dad comes in, and, I was like, oh, hey, thanks for this. He got me this Peeps lollipop. It's like, he got me this Peeps lollipop. See? And people, me and my dad, we have this joke because we both think Peeps are literally disgusting. So, like every Easter time, like, he always gets me some kind of Peeps thing. And then I always send him, like, pictures and, like, stuff. Like, oh my god, Peeps are so nasty. But, like, I don't know. It's just a mutual hate that we have about Peeps. But we just make it into a joke anyway. So he... I was like, oh, thanks for the Peeps lollipop. He's like, oh, you're welcome. Like, he was in a good mood. And then he saw that note. He's like, what is this? I was like, I don't know. I just left that there for you. I was like, I don't know anything about it. He was reading it, and I could tell he was getting so mad. I was like, yeah, because when it has to do with Ed, like, it's just stupid fuckery. It's just stupid. I'm like, I mean, I don't want to say too much, but. It's just, that's why he always talks about stupid stuff. So he was reading it, he got mad. I was like, uh-oh. Oh, someone's gonna get an ass whooping. And then, so my dad's like, he was getting really mad. He's like breathing heavily, like, so then he was like trying to get a hold of Ed, but like he wasn't answering his phone, probably because he's driving, slash he's like so old that he probably can't hear his phone ring. Anyway, so my dad's keep on calling him. And, like, I can hear through my dad's phone that keeps on going to voicemail. So my dad makes another phone call, and when I guess what happened was that, it's so stupid. My dad, like, had these new pants on for his uniform. And then Ed was like, I guess Ed said, oh, those are good-looking pants. So my dad's like, okay, hey, we'll get you some. So he made an order for Ed to go pick up these pants. And I guess when he got there, Ed was, like, told the lady at the place, like, oh, just kidding. Actually, I don't really like these pants. Can I get these pants instead? And then I guess the lady was, like, confused because she didn't want to, like, do something that was against what my dad had ordered because my dad's the boss. My dad's paying for it. So that's what the note was about, like, Ed telling him, like, oh, I don't really want those pants anymore. I want a different pants. And my dad was just telling me, like, like, yeah, he's like that. Like, if he doesn't like a uniform, he won't wear it. I'm like, are you serious? Are you serious? Like, I think he's like 70 or 75. Like, old man has a problem with his boring ass security guard pants. What? I mean, honestly, what is the difference? They basically all look the same, just, like, boring colors, boring style. Like, there's nothing special about it. So why would he be like, oh my god, I don't want to wear those pants. Like, he's, like, a 15-year-old girl, you know, like, being forced to wear, like, I don't know, like, a sandwich costume or something. Like, something stupid. It's, like, dumb. I'm like, oh my god, are you serious? Like, anytime I've ever had to wear a uniform, like, of course, it hasn't always been, like, you know, something cute. It has never been something cute, but it's a uniform. It's part of the job. You just wear it. Who cares? It's not like it's your normal clothes. like it's stupid. I was just like, oh my God, so dumb. All that drama. Just because I don't want to wear those pants. And then my dad's like, yeah. I was like, might as well just get him what he wants. He's like, because if I, buy him these pants and he's not going to wear them, that's just wasted money. I'm like, oh, so stupid. Dumb fuckery.
Well, okay, I'm driving right now, but anyways, let me just tell you, there is some pet peeves that I have, okay? Like, everyone has pet peeves. But listen, this is like one of the ones that's just like, I was just on my Instagram and this girl posts a picture of her hair and she's like, I'm blonde for right now or whatever. Her hair was orange. Her hair was not blonde. It was orange. It's just like those girls that get an ombre. The tips of their hair is like really, really lightened. And the rest of their hair is like brown or whatever, whatever. Oh my God, you guys, I'm blonde. You are not blonde. You have an ombre and the tips of your hair are blonde. You are not blonde. The top of your head is brown or black or whatever the fuck. Like, if you want to call yourself blonde so bad, go blonde. Like, why do you have to say that? Oh my God, I'm a blondie now. I have blonde highlights and the rest of my hair is black. Oh my God, I'm such a Barbie. No, you are not. You have blonde highlights. You have a blonde ombre. Your hair is orange because you did not tone your hair. It is orange, girlfriend. You are not blonde. Okay? In case you were thinking that one, small piece of hair on your entirely black or brown or red hair. I don't even know what the fuck I'm saying right now. But it's just so annoying. Like, if you want to call yourself blonde so bad, stop being afraid of it and just dye and just bleach it all blonde then. Like, that's what I hate. Ugh, hate it so bad. It's like, oh my God, yeah, I like made such a drastic change. No, you did not, girlfriend. A percentage of your hair is lighter. Most of the time, I would not consider it blonde. Most of the time, it's like light brown or orange. You are not blonde, okay? People, I just want to let you know that. This bleach, look it. Bleach the fuck out. That's blonde. You are not blonde. You are not blonde. Just saying. Just like saying, like, don't know. It's just annoying. Because, it is what it is. You are not blonde. It's like saying if I had, like, the tips of my hair were like red. Oh my God, I'm a redhead now. You guys, I'm a redhead. Lol, the ends of your hair are red. You are not a redhead. You feel me? It's the same thing. Like, I know a lot of girls, wish they were blonde. I mean, a lot of girls don't wish they were blonde. They're fine with whatever hair color they have, but I'm just saying. You want to do it so bad, then do it. Stop being afraid of it. That's what a lot of people are. People tell me all the time, like, oh, I wish I could, dye my hair blonde or bleach my hair blonde, but I'm so scared. So they do like a tiny, minimal little part. Cool, good job. You're like breaking out of your comfort zone, or maybe you're not, but cool. You did it a little bit, but you are not blonde. You are not blonde. I'm just saying. That just gets me so mad. Anyways, I just wanted to finish this vlog with Minnie. It is still Monday. It's like 10 or something. I don't really know. But anyways, listen to me. So, since the last time I saw you, I went to hang out with one of my new friends, Alex. And she found me through YouTube, and then she kept on like commenting and
She was following me on Twitter, and so I was like, I'm going to see. Minnie, stop. I was like, I'm going to see what this girl's about. So I check her profile. Turns out she, like, lives near me, and I'm like, oh, my God. So, like, I started following her, and we started talking, and I always follow her on Snapchat. She always has, like, the most real stuff to say. Turns out she has a YouTube channel, too, but she doesn't really post, which I'm like, girl, you are the real. First things first, you're the realest, so you need to post more. But anyways, and then I saw her like a few weeks ago. I just ran into her at a Starbucks that I always go to. I'm like, oh my God, girl, hey. And we're like talking, and then we like exchanged phone numbers. So we've been trying to hang out ever since. So we finally hung out. We went to In-N-Out. We had our typical Cali girls. And we had In-N-Out. Minnie. Wiggle, wiggle, wiggle. And then, sorry. My bae's texting me. Okay. What was I saying? And then we went to Target and I picked up some thotties. Where are they? Minnie, stop. They were 30% off. They only had these kind, the like individual ones. So I took as many as I could afford because, yeah, don't really have a lot of money. But, and then after that, I took a Pilates class, not Pilates, yoga class. And I came home and I'd just been effing around. So what was the point of this? Oh, why I decided to pick up the camera and talk to you guys? Because it's just so funny. I find it really funny how when girls start something with I find it funny, it's not funny. They are mad. So I always see, I think maybe I've talked about it before, I don't really know. But I always see, I mean, I follow, you know, different people on Instagram. You know, a lot of guys on Instagram, a lot of girls on Instagram, you know, whatever. And I always see guys post stuff saying like, oh my God, goofy girls are the best. Funny girlfriends are the best. Weird girls are the best. Like, why are you describing me though? But like, you're not with me though. Like, everyone always tells me, oh my God, you are so funny. Girls and guys. And I always say, oh my God, you are so goofy. Girls and guys. Oh my God, you are so weird. Girls and guys both tell me all that stuff. But like, are there guys around me? Where are they at though? Because no one's trying to get with me though. You feel? And I mean, I feel like it's different. Minnie, stop. And you're just gonna start. It's different when, you know, there's just some, like, people on the internet leaving, you know, kissy emojis or whatever. I feel like it's different than, like, in real life, you feel? Because in real life, no one's trying to get with me. No one is. So I just find that really funny how, you know, guys say they like a certain kind of thing. But, like, where are they? Are they here? Do they really like that? Because I'm literally the weirdest girl, the weirdest person you will ever meet. But, like, they run from me, so Minnie knows. Minnie's always here. Look at her.
Look at her.
Minnie, I love you. Don't go breaking my heart. No, she wants to leave. Cool. Isn't that the story of my life, though? Just what I'm saying. Everyone runs from me. Anyways. Minnie Mouse. She, like, smells gross, but I still love to smell her. It's weird. I think it's because I love her. I bet you my bae could smell, like, poop or garbage, and I'd still be like, oh my God, I love him. Love the way he smells. Pace! This shit on the desk has been here for months, literally, and I never want to do it. So today my dad's like, you have to do this today. And I'm like, fuck, I hate my life.